Let me speak. Your name still hurts to call. Preacher, keep it brief. I'm pulling out. Today I come to you with a tale and a warning, maybe, about confirmation bias and how some things sounding better is all in here and not in here. Back in October, I went to mix with the Masters with Chris Lord-Alge, spent a week with him, lovely guy. Learnt from him and had my mind blown with his wizardry. And this kind of changed my outlook trajectory, I guess. Changed my outlook on mixing, definitely. And I feel like, and it could be wrong, but I feel like ever since I came back, my mixes have just way better. It's like I see things in a different light now. Anyway, Chris mixes on a console, for any of you that are unfamiliar. He mixes on an SSL 4000E. Obviously, I don't have one of those, nor do I have the nuclear power plant to run one at the house. So that was out of the question. But I got onto the idea of summing mixers, and I thought, did a little bit of research online and saw what other people thought about them. And to me, the concept of it made total sense. You know, you take the audio out of the digital domain, and you sum it together in the analog realm. And I was thinking, well, kind of some of the way Chris gets his sound is sort of by driving the console. Anyway, I thought, summing mixer. So I had a little look around, I had a look at some options, and I ultimately settled upon the Dangerous Music Tubus LT, the little purple one. Plugged it in, cool. Ran a mix through it, cool. Does it make a massive difference? Well, I was like, yeah, I can hear what this is doing. This is amazing. Super happy. So I started mixing into it, did a few records through it, until I started to run out of I.O. for gear. See, the thing with a summing mixer is it takes a lot of I.O. 16 outputs and 2 returns. Well, anyway, I was loaning a piece of gear from a friend and I just didn't have the available I.O. for it. So I took the decision to bypass the summing mixer through the patch bay to plug this other gear in. And I thought, well, for what it's worth, I'll bounce this track without it. I did a bounce of this track. Then I started listening to the one that had bounced through the summing mixer and the one that had bounced without the summing mixer, and I couldn't hear a difference. Maybe a tiny bit in the top end, but it wasn't like,
Jesus Christ!
Oh my God! Wow!
No. It was just like, oh. So I labelled the mixes A and B, and I sent them over to the friend I'd loaned the gear from and said, hey, dude, listen to these. Tell me which one you think's better. Which one sounds better? He couldn't really pick between them. Said they sounded absolutely identical. Ultimately, I have come to realise that the summing mixer doesn't really do that much. Now, that's not to say all summing mixers don't do anything, but the Dangerous one certainly doesn't. It's or at least it's very, very transparent to the point where it renders itself useless. Now, I know that, you know, Neve and a couple of other people make summing boxes which have tubes in them or, you know, other kind of saturation or whatever. Without having tried any of these, I think they will make a difference, because when you really think about it, that's kind of what the difference is in a console. It's the micro amounts of saturation that happen channel to channel to channel, which kind of build up to a bigger picture. And that's why they sound so wide and so open and so huge. A summing mixer, unless it has that saturation kind of built in, just doesn't really give you that. Certainly not a transparent one. Now, I'm not saying that summing mixers are bad. I think the process of using one and having that experience taught me a couple of things about mixing, or at least facilitated me mixing in a different way. Would I have come to this conclusion without using it? Maybe, maybe not. Did you hear a difference? Because the track I played on the introduction was actually AB clips of the mix that didn't have the summing and the mix that did have the summing. Did you hear anything, really? If you did, legitimately, let me know in the comments. I'd be interested to know, because I'm not saying anybody's wrong here. Some people may be able to hear something that I'm not hearing, but to me, it's pretty difficult to tell the difference between them. At least to the point of diminishing returns, because summing mixers are not cheap. So when you think about the price of entry, are you getting that much out of it? I'd probably say you're not. For most people, again, this is a broad and general statement, for most people. That's pretty much it. That's my experience with the summing mixer. I guess the overarching tale here, or the point I was trying to make, was it's easy to validate your purchase, and it's easy to go down the route of, yeah, this sounds amazing, because your heart wants to believe that that's true. Would I have come to this conclusion if I'd spent some time really critically listening, maybe performing a null test on it? Probably. But that didn't suit the agenda. The agenda was, I'm going to sound like I've got a console. This is awesome. So when the mix sounded good, which could be a myriad of other reasons why, I was like, this is a summing mixer. This thing sounds absolutely amazing. And I started using it. Confirmation bias. I wanted to believe it was great. Have a great day. Thanks a lot for subscribing. For those of you that do, and for those of you that don't, help a brother out. Other than that, be well, and I'll see you in the next...